It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Yusuke Yodatani. He earned his master's in medical pharmacology from Hoshi University, and today he is a very respected bacteriologist at the Kawasaki City Institute for Public Health with expertise in culture, PCR, and SNP analysis. Thank you.
Thank you for the introduction. It's a great honor to be able to speak to you today. Before I start, I'd like to thank IDEX Laboratories for this opportunity and organizer. I'd like to talk about the usefulness of the regional quantity drain method in bath water. The number of legionellosis cases is increasing every year in Japan. In 2020, 2,059 cases were reported with an incidence of 1.64 cases per million people. In 2020, with the outbreak of COVID-19, respiratory infections, including pneumococcal infections, significantly decreased. A case of IPD decreased by 50%, but those of legionellosis by only 10%. 32.5% of legionellosis cases in Japan are suspected waterborne infections. Japan has many public bathhouses and hot springs, and many people use them. So legionella control measures in public baths are important to reduce the incidence of legionellosis. The public bath law in Japan stipulates that legionella species should not be detected in public baths, including hot springs. Therefore, facility managers are required to conduct regular inspection for legionella presence. Legionella testing is one of the most important tests for public health in our local health laboratories. The plate culture method is generally used for this purpose. However, this method requires a complex procedure, including a sample concentration process, and depend on the characteristics of the sample. The culture takes 7 to 10 days, and controlling the accuracy of this test is challenging. We conduct a comparative study of the regional QT and the plate culture method applied to 599 bath water samples, mainly from hot springs in Japan. The regional QT method was performed using the 10 milliliter protocol, which I will elaborate in the next slide. Wells that were determined to be positive were re-incubated to confirm the presence of legionella species. In the plate culture method, the samples were concentrated by filtration and cultured for 7 days to detect legionella species. We also detected the genes of legionella species using genetic testing. Here, I will briefly introduce the 10 milliliter protocol used in study. First, 10 milliliter of the samples is added to dissolve the regional liquid medium. The sample is stored in a dedicated tray and cultured for 7 days. After incubation, the wells that turn brown are considered positive, as shown here. The positive wells were counted, and the most probable number table is used to obtain the MPN value. This kit is easy to use and can specifically detect and quantify legionella pneumophila in the samples. Let's see the results. The qualitative results of the methods are shown in this table. 136 cases were both positive, and 365 were both negative, with a concordance rate of 83.6%. Legionella pneumophila was the most detected species, and some other species, like Longicidinis micdati, also detected. Legionella pneumophila cell group 1 was the most predominantly detected cell groups in the region animalcula, followed by cell group 6, 5, and 3. Next, we compare the number of Legionella species in the 136 cases that tested positive using both the methods. The vertical axis plots the number of species detected using the plate culture method, and the horizontal axis plots the number of species detected using the Legionella QT method. As shown in the graph, a higher number of Legionella indicates a higher correlation. Two methods were strongly correlated. Next, I'll talk about cases where the number of detected Legionella were inconsistent between both the methods. The graph on the left depicts the amount of Legionella detected via the Legionella QT method. The plate culture method is depicted on the right. The positive genetic tests are highlighted in purple, and the negative results are indicated in blue. Of the 98 inconsistent samples, 73 contained less than 30 CFU or MPN per 100 milliliter of Legionella. Among 35 inconsistent samples, 7 were negative by genetic testing, and tests were also inconsistent. We tried to isolate Legionella pneumophila from the 37 samples which tested positive only using the Legionella QT method. Of those, we could isolate Legionella pneumophila from 17 Legionella cultures. This result indicates that Legionella could be detected only using the Legionella QT method. In any case, the results of the two methods may not match when the sample contains a very small number of Legionella. Conversely, no Legionella pneumophila was detected in some Legionella culture, and we confirmed that different bacterial species were growing these samples. After isolating these species, we examined whether they could cause false positive using the Legionella QT method. And fourth species, these fourth species did. These species are mainly isolated from aquatic environments and are likely present in bath water, such as Legionella. Additionally, three of the four samples from which these species were isolated had a low regional chlorine concentration, suggesting that this infection was not sufficient, causing proliferation and the positive result in the Legionella QT method. Our results suggest such species may give false positive result in the Legionella QT assay, especially in samples that have been adequately disinfected. But it's a very rare case. Other samples that have been inadequately disinfected results match the plate culture method. But we need to know these cases. I'd like to summarize these results. The Legionella QT method can selectively detect Legionella pneumophila qualitatively and quantitatively, equivalent to the plate culture method. The Legionella QT method can be executed with a smaller amount of sample and is easier to operate and evaluate than the plate culture method. Conversely, rare samples can show false positive. Moreover, discrepancy between the two methods occur when the sample has very low amount of Legionella. Based on these results, we conclude that the Legionella QT method can be successfully used for inspecting the water quality in samples, such as bath water. Last but not the least, this research was conducted with these collaborators, and we would like to thank all of them. And this research was supported by a Health and Labor Science Research Grant. With this, I'd like to close my presentation. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much.